Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to MAGHA Academy, School of Learning Science. So, today's session is the part 3 of our learning article series. And part 1, I have already explained you this diagram, this pictographic code. This pictographic code, we are going to use it to learn the articles for the prelims exam and to analyze the current events for mains exam. So let me begin with the show. Today is a show time. Now let me introduce the first figure to you. The first figure has part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4 and part 5. Okay, so and also let me give you a brief introduction to this figure. This figure is a democracy code, a democracy figure. The three important things necessary for democracy: independent judiciary, fair and free election, and the body and power dynamics. The body president, Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha has taken three bodies we have taken over here. And they have power, so their own, everybody has their own power. So this is the play of democracy. This is a code of democracy. Okay, so let me start with the today's session, and 5 parts are here to explain the article. The articles. Okay. So 71 and 72 I have kept deliberately on the side of judiciary because it shows the president and judiciary relationship. The first 71 is the election matter of president are entertained by a Supreme Court. All election matters. So his election matter goes to Supreme Court. And 72 is his judicial power, in which he can pardon, respite, remit, and commute. So the first part is the relationship between president and the judiciary. And move on to the second part. The second part is the executive. He has the executive power. So in 53 article we have already read out that 53 is the head of the executive. In 73 the extent of the executive power, it extends parallel to the law making power of the parliament. So this is the executive, and 77 says that all the work are done on his name. So these three components are very important for executive power. And there is article 70 also which says that in certain contingency parliament can give the power, certain increase the power of the executive power of the president. So that also comes in. So 53, 73, 77. Easy to remember, 53, 73. Not very hard in 77. Okay. Now 74 and 78 has to be read all together. Both of them together. Because this shows the president and some relationship with the parliament. 74. The aid and advice of the Council of Ministers. It works on aid and advice, but Prime Minister has a duty to furnish with him information. So this all is these two important articles has to be read together. That is aid and advice 74. We all We all should remember this article. This is a very important article, which makes President the titular head and Prime Minister as a real head. So, moving on to the fourth part, 45 and 46. This is ministers. And okay, let me explain this Lok Sabha internal diagram. So after general election, the members comes in the Lok Sabha, and from them the majority forms the majority party, who got the maximum number of seats forms the government. So here comes the Council of Ministers and the head Prime Minister. Of course, they can be from ministers can be from Rajya Sabha or PM can be from the Rajya Sabha. So, but it forms like this from the members. So it shows that parliamentary democracy exists in India. This Article 75 shows that parliamentary democracy exists in India, and the ministers and prime minister holds responsibility, collective responsibility to the Lok Sabha, and individual responsibility to the president. So collectively they are responsible for Lok Sabha. And this is very important article in the parliamentary democracy. Now next to the minister comes the, and here also in 75 there is an oath of the minister, and next to the minister comes the Attorney General. The Attorney General has same rights and privileges as the minister in committees and voting on that. So first part was that relationship between the president and the judiciary, then the executive 53, 73 and 77, then the relationship, very important relationship between the president and parliament, and 75, 76 for the ministers. With this diagram, from 71 to 78 article, you should remember each and every article. If you will challenge your brain, revise again and again, you will master it. And the recording will be very fast, everywhere, with accuracy. In prelims, accuracy matters, and in mains, the speed matters. So, 85, 86, 87, 88, these four articles, you have to write it, you have to connect it with this diagram, this code. And 85, 86, 87, 88 are important articles. Let me show you. 85, summoning of parliament, prorogation and dissolution. And from dissolution comes one discretionary power of the president, that he, if the prime minister loses the majority and he says that dissolve the Lok Sabha, then he can take his own decision. 86 and 87. 86 is he addresses the parliament, and special address 86, 87. So he has a right to address in 86 and special address. Both the articles are to address the parliament. Special address 87. 88 is the right of the ministers. Right of the ministers. So in this diagram, you have to deal with president, ministers, and parliamentary democracy, aid and advice, executive power of the president. Now let me come to the second diagram. Here you have to remember the two numbers 79 and 89. Now what is 79? You have to write it exactly, and you have to think exactly in the same way. The 79 is the constitution of the parliament. 80, 81, 82, 83, 84. Rajya Sabha, composition of Rajya Sabha, 80, composition of Lok Sabha, 81, and 82 for readjustment, 83 for dissolution. The Lok Sabha gets dissolved every 5 years automatically, and Rajya Sabha never. And 84 is qualification. So these articles should be in your mind. 80 Rajya Sabha, 81 should be in your mind, should be pictographically comes to your mind. Okay, you should be accurate in that. Now if we have created Rajya Sabha, then we go to 89. So 89 creates the post chairman and deputy chairman for Rajya Sabha, and 90 says the vacant and resignation. And when the vacancy arrives, deputy chairman acts as a, or other person acts as a chairman. So I always remember this by an arrow, the third article shows an arrow. Of course, the 92 is who will preside when the resolution for removal. And same, so you have to count it down. 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96 for a speaker. And they got some two articles, salary and secretariat. So after forming all these bodies, the procedure starts. The business, conduct of business starts. How they are going to, what major functions of this all bodies. So let me begin with 99 and 100. 99 is vote. 100 is voting. Forum and all procedure happening in the parliament, and 101. I always remember it with the zero in the mid. So vacant seat. It can be seen as a vacant seat. 102, disqualification. 103, decision of the president is final, the matter of disqualification. So 103 is an important power of president. 104, penalty. And 105 is very important article, right and privileges of the members. And 106 is oath, salary of the members. So in the next session we will be dealing with state elections, state articles, and state articles in this format remains the same. I will explain you in the next video, and also we are explaining the parliament. So we will move to state articles in the next session. Be with us. Thank you.